My name is John Hedengren. I'm an NCAA cross-country All-American and engineering professor. This is my daughter, Jane, finishing a race. And I just took a clip of that and uploaded it to alphapeak.io. We'll go to AlphaForm. It'll take you through a couple steps just to give you some instructions about how to upload the video. It's free to do this. You come down to the third step. I'm going to select for my daughter, analyze hips. I want to look at the contralateral hip drop. It's a measure of efficiency, but also risk for injury, especially right at the end of her race. So I'll upload that file and then look for less than 7 degree hip drop as she's coming into the finish. This is one example of the analysis that we can do. McGyver Clark of AlphaPeak took the TimpView program with 7 athletes qualifying for state and transformed the program into a powerhouse with 28 athletes qualifying for state. He's going to show a more in-depth analysis for his sprint mechanics in the sprinter group.
What's up, guys? This is MacGyver with AlphaPeak, and today we're going to talk about how AlphaForm can help you analyze the maximum velocity of your sprinters. So today we have an athlete, Haven Halliday. He is a sprinter at Timpview High School. He's now graduated, but here we have him doing a 50-meter full a maximum velocity wicket drill, okay, and we've processed this video through the AlphaForm software. And so essentially what the software does is it pinpoints the joint center positions, and then from that data we can calculate many descriptive statistics about the athlete. This athlete, he is running full speed, and these wickets are spaced out progressively longer at every stride. And the goal of this drill is to reach your top speed, and then we measure key characteristics about the form. Now with AlphaForm, what we can do is we can then take that video, and then we can measure key parameters that will help us analyze and figure out areas where we can improve. Okay, so here we have a stride rate, and so we can see for the 5 steps with the left leg, and mind you that this data is just for the left leg, we can see that he started out at about 4.2 steps per second, and by the end, as his stride length increased, his stride rate decreased to about 3.9 steps. So if I was to draw an average line through this graph, it'd be somewhere right around here, about 4.2 steps per second. Now, this is an early season video, and so through seasonal progression, we will want to see this number increase. Now, you see this blue area right here? This is what elite sprinters can hold at their maximal velocity. This is right around 4.7 to 4.8 even steps per second. Now, this is given that the rest of the biomechanics of the stride is also within good parameters. So as I scroll down, so number 2, we have ground contact time. So the AlphaForm, it automates the measurement of time while the foot is on the ground. Okay, so as we can see, it measures the time when the foot hits the ground and then when the foot leaves the ground. Okay, so you can see it's very small numbers, right? However, we want to minimize ground contact time, right? So the ground, it's a great thing. That's how we produce force. But the friction and braking force that you have from the ground as you stride is also the greatest braking force that a sprinter has, as it is trying to create maximal horizontal velocity. And so as you can see, as we go through, he actually right around 0.1 seconds is good. Okay. However, we want to get down into the 0.09 area. So what we'd like to see, so you know, if we were to draw an average here, we're right around, you know, 0.102, and we would like to see that number definitely decrease. So there are many other things that we can measure. So maximum hip flexion at every stride. So this is something that is one of Haven's strengths. That's one of the reasons why he's so strong in the back half of the 400, is because his knee drive, so this angle right here, is phenomenal, okay? He's always getting his knees up, and really, you know, what we want to teach athletes is not to get their knee up, but to get their knee out. Excuse me, to get their knee out, okay? And so you can see that if we were to draw an average in this graph, okay, He is right at the bottom of what elite sprinters can hold. And so that's what we'd want to keep. Now, as we increase his stride rate, right, we want to keep that hip flexion and that stride length constant while we increase that speed. And obviously that's going to create a higher horizontal velocity. So there are other things that we can measure as far as maximum knee flexion, touchdown trunk angle, okay? And this is something that Haven does a very good job. He's not too tall, but he's also not bent over. He's at a good optimal angle, okay, off the trunk at touchdown, okay? There's a knee separation at touchdown, and then horizontal foot distance from the center of mass at touchdown, okay? So here is the analysis all put together in one page, okay? So you have stride rate, ground contact time, maximum hip angle, maximum knee angle, etc. Okay, and these are biomechanics standard measurements that we want to be looking at. Now, the great thing is we've also included AlphaTrainer, which is a custom AI built on biomechanic information to critique and to coach and to analyze all of the data that came from the analysis and summarize it. And so here we see that it gives Haven three things that it did well and one thing that it can improve. So it says our knee flexion looks very, very good, right? Our trunk angle at touchdown looks very good, and our knee separation at touchdown looks very good. So all of those things, very good. Very, very, very good, okay? Now there's one specific thing he can do to improve, and we want to focus on increasing stride rate, okay? As a coach, if I were to manually go through all of this data, that is also what I would say is the number one thing that we can do to improve. And so the AI is very good at taking all of the data, looking at all of the parameters of the athlete, and then making a informed recommendation for coaches and athletes on what to focus on. And so what we'd want to see is, okay, so what are some things that we can do to increase stride rate? And so obviously that's going to be, that's going to be drills that increase turnover. That's going to be glute, hamstring, and core strength. And not only just strength, but also explosiveness. Okay. Some other things that we can do as far as injury prevention, as we are working on turnover, so full speed sprints, flying 30s, wicket drills, etc. Okay, as we are adding more volume to these areas, then we also want to help bulletproof those areas. And so things like eccentric exercises would be eccentrics would be great. So these are like Nordic hamstring curls. Okay. So as a coach, you know, I would take this video. It took about 20 seconds, 30 seconds for me to film. I process it with AlphaForm. I get all of this information automatically generated with a small AI help tool to help focus your search. As a coach, you can read all the raw data and make your decisions yourself. Or if you want a little bit of help, we provide it automatically through AlphaTrainer. And then as a coach, I would say, okay, for Haven Halliday, we need to work on stride rate. That is what we are going to focus on. So for the next month of training, that's what we're going to focus on. And then we're going to test again, and then we can measure, okay, how have we improved over time? So obviously we would love to see that improvement in race times. That would be the number one way that we can measure how we're improving. Let's just play this back. But also the power with AlphaForm and AlphaTrainer is that you can test as many times as you want. And so, you know, if we have a good training buildup where we get 3 weeks of good lifting, good form work, great top speed mechanics, maybe a race or two, then in a month, I can test them again and I can measure, okay, are we improving in this aspect? Or do we need to make decisions that are strategic so that we can work on the most important aspects of this athlete's training at the key times of the training season so we can make the most out of every season and reach the potential of every athlete. And so furthermore, this is just one athlete. So for coaches, it is an amazing tool where you can automatically process all of your athletes in a very short amount of time. So every athlete gets the same amount of attention, the same amount of coaching, and has expert analysis for everybody. Data is tracked, recommendations are made, and athletes improve. And this is a tool that we are developing at AlphaPeak. We're very passionate about it, and we want to maximize the potential and longevity of all athletes. And thank you for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.